are still not a sporting nation. We do not have systems, we do not have structures, but we do have a dream. A dream of winning 10 medals in Tokyo 2020. A dream of sport for all. A dream that tells us that sport is about learning. It is about a quest for excellence and is about development. And the one man who has helped nurture this dream, ignite this dream, is none other than Pullela Gopichand.
Well, when I won the All England and before the All England, it was almost that I would go to the stadium and many things which are normal or which are needed to be a player were not in place. Things, shuttles, courts, coaches, players, gym, track, recovery pool, all of these things were a big challenge. So for me, when I won the All England, it almost felt as though that I had a formula to win, but I needed a place to use it and people to use it, and started coaching in 2004. Almost abruptly, my playing career was stopped and got into coaching. And then I needed the academy because I couldn't have these variables all the time. We were operating out of the Gachibowli Stadium in the initial years. As a player, it's not possible that you can have breaks in training. And one of the fundamental things was to have infrastructure which we are able to keep open all the time, because as a sport, we've worked on Diwalis, we've worked on Christmas, we've worked on New Year's, because for us, the player's schedule is what is most important.
Committed, determined and passionate in producing the next PV Sindhu, the next Saina Nehwal, the next Kidambi Srikanth. From morning till night, day in, day out, 365 days of the year, year after year, he is dedicated to one cause, to make Indian sport the talking point of this world.
This is like a temple of badminton, like for badminton. Any player who can get at this place, definitely his entire badminton requirements are taken care of here, because the on-court playing part, then the physical training, then the weight training, strengthening, it is taken care individually from player to player. Every player, some basic strength training programs are there. But specifically, someone requires more, that also is taken care of.
The main person behind this is Gopi sir. So before, we didn't have such infrastructure. So once Gopichand Academy came up, then the work which Gopi sir have been doing, like he's on the court from 4:30 till 12:30, then again at from 3 to almost 7. So he has been doing this for a long time. So that's the main reason I would say Saina has come up, Sindhu has come up, Srikanth, Pranoy, Sai, Samir, Saurav, Guru, Kashyap. So whoever has come up, it's because of him, because of his hard work he has put behind. So much of time he has spent for this. So that the result is showing, his hard work, the results have been coming because of his hard work.
He has a desire inside to do something. जब ये खेलता था तब भी इसमें ऐसी जुनून था, अब जैसे ही कोच बना वही जुनून इज कंटिन्यू कि मुझे कुछ करना है, हर चीज़ के बाद कुछ ना कुछ आगे करने की सोचता है. सो वो बहुत ज़रूरी है, अगर जुनून है तो सब कुछ है.
डे स्टार्ट्स अर्ली, गेट अप एट 3:30 इन द मॉर्निंग, रीच हियर बाय अराउंड 4:15. Our first session start then, and I kind of finish off the sessions in the morning by around 11:30, 12, and stay back at the academy for a few hours, And evening again, we have sessions starting at 3 o'clock. Stay till around 6 o'clock at the academy. Go back home, and dinner is normally before 7. And I hit the bed by 8:30. So kind of very simple routine, because I don't do anything more than this when I'm in Hyderabad.
An academy like this is not set up overnight. So if you think all of a sudden India got a state-of-the-art academy and you started producing Olympic champions, it's never the case. It was in 2003-04, when Gopi was injured, that the thought of this academy first came to him. At that point in time, he got a group of kids from the Gachibowli Stadium to this academy, and they just had started. The facilities were very rudimentary. He put in his own money, he put in his own funds, he went to people requesting with the begging bowl, please back me. It wasn't easy. In fact, if you ask Gopi, he will tell you that as an All England champion, he had to give up on all his ego, because people saw him and ran away. Arre, phir paisa mangne aa gaya hai. Imagine what he must have been going through. At that point in time, his mom, who administers this academy, was suffering from cancer. He had two children, one age 1, 1 2. So his wife was totally preoccupied with them. He would come to the academy in the morning, stay till midnight. It often happened that he went to sleep in the car and the police came and woke him up. Finally, in 2006-07, when he had a government grant of 10 lakh rupees, was revoked. You know what he decided? He decided to mortgage his Jubilee Hills house, and that Jubilee Hills house gave him some 3 crore rupees to develop this academy. It is a story of real hardship, real struggle, real commitment, real passion.
In 2002, land was given after Gopi's All England win, land was given to him by then government. But after, they didn't give any money or any support. Land was given in 2002 and started the building the academy in 2004. After that, one Mr. Prasad Garu helped us a lot. And with some sponsors, and we mortgaged our house in Jubilee Hills to get some loan and to complete the academy. Complete in the sense, first stage of badminton courts. And after that, one by one, we added the other facilities to the academy.
I think the initial years, the sheer energy to do something was so much that I don't know what all I have put in the sense. Time and energy was one, but resources to employ people, to buy shuttles and to get basic things in place were also coming from my pocket. So it was almost like I was coaching. Not only was I spending my time and energy, but also putting my money to actually do this. So the initial years were tough. Today when I think of the kind of risks we have taken, this academy, the plan, grand plan, there was nothing in the pocket to start off with, no contribution to start off with. And I wanted this room like this, which can oversee the badminton courts. I wanted rooms like these, the kids can come down and play. I wanted a gym here so that they come out and they can sprint. I wanted a pool down so that they can go out there. So all of these things, and at least 8 courts so that we have a decent number to start off with. Today, looking at the growth of the sport, I think it looks phenomenal. I've been very lucky that it's not that I've been super motivated every single morning from the day we started. I think there have been tough times, whether it's getting corporate funding to build the academy or to have multiple bosses at associations and SAI and government, or when we had to fight 6 long years of court cases with the government. It's been tough, and with players it's also been sometimes tough. So it's been, my motivation has been up most of the time, but it's been points of low as well. I think what's really been super help, what's really been grace, I would think, is the family's solid support. In fact, whenever I've been down, for me, luckily, my mother, my father and Lakshmi, they're part of the academy. I've actually had my family stay up and take care of the academy as much. So that is an aspect which I don't think is replaceable. I think for me, if I were to talk about why Gopichand may not happen so often, it's the fact that it's the family's support which
Team Gopichand is.
Team Gopichand is.
I think when it comes to Gopi, definitely he has sacrificed a lot and he is sacrificing. From our side, definitely we think that way, but Gopi takes it as a passion. He never says, I have sacrificed and stuff. He says, I have passion and I want Indian players to be on the top of the world. And I think that keeps him going. So whatever sacrifices he makes, from his side, he doesn't see that as a sacrifice. He sees it as his passion.
It's a state-of-the-art academy with multiple. There are about 300-350 students who come here and train, from the highest elite sportsperson to the absolute youngster from the age of 5 onward. It's a brilliant, brilliant effort which India has got over the last 15 years. Started in 2004, and the journey, as we have said, is continuing.
There are all the facilities, including the swimming pool. Physios are there round the clock over here. So even after the injury, the rehab is also much faster. So this place is like a center which has all the facilities which is required for a top level athlete or an athlete or a badminton player to reach to the top level also.
There's only one place we'll have to go for our track running session, that is the Gachibowli Stadium. Apart from that, everything is taken care here. There's a swimming pool here, so it's not more I can ask for.
The level of intensity and practice, the level is good here, and the shuttle quality is also very good. And there is a talk with Gopi sir every day about how to play, how will I improve my game and all.
There are many seniors here to tell us, and the coaches are also of different level. Gopi sir and our leader of the batch, Anil sir, is also very good.
Practice and seniors. I exchange words with Saina Didi. She used to support me, like, do this, do that, and your this thing is good, that thing is not good, so work on that. So she says.
So I think food, stay, recovery, training, coaches, supports team, everything is located at the academy. So if you have an interest and if you want to push yourself, this place is available for you 24/7.
It is very rare that a corporate comes to an academy, speaks to the coach and says, we are not interested in the players, but we are interested in backing you and the academy. And that's what happened with IDBI Federal Life Insurance and Pullela Gopichand's academy. Soon after Rio, they set up a meeting. Whole world was talking about PV Sindhu, justly so. They came over, Gopi had thought it was all about Sindhu and endorsement. It wasn't. It was about supporting the academy, how to think long term, how to work together, partner together, and subsequently was launched the Quest for Excellence program.
I think for me, IDBI Federal Life Insurance to come on board has been a huge support. I think.
Were you surprised that they came and said they wanted to support you and not Sindhu?
I was very surprised. When they came up and said we want to support you and celebrate the coach bit of it, I was like, can you say it again? Kind of it.
When Sindhu won the silver at the Rio Olympics, that is when Vignesh and I were discussing, and we said, I think we should meet up with Gopi and see what is it and how is it that we can support the sport of badminton.
The only thing we told them is that we're not looking at Saina, we're not looking at Srikanth, we're not looking at Sindhu. We're looking at the next Indian medalist in 2024 and 28. And that's where the court stuck with Gopi. And that was his passion also. And that's how Quest for Excellence was born.
A six-year-old is in wherever he is. He goes from home, from his sleeping in his bed and with the parents, eating home food, going and getting quality coaching wherever he is. I think that's a great model to have. And a system which actually brings the best talent out and then gets the right kind of coaching which is required and the right structure which is required. The quest for excellence would mean a quest across all spheres and starting to look at a hub and spoke model where the best practices are shared with the corners of the country and where it matters, and then the kids take it up from there.
Also, in a few months from then, they launched the Young Champs program to moot young talent and develop young talent. It was a special partnership, the partnership that still carries on, the partnership that is flowing change, is giving us future badminton players, all emerging in this particular academy in Hyderabad. So it's an initiative that India should replicate across sports, because unless you go and fund at the grassroots, you fund the process, you will not have a system or a supply chain. That is what is important, not simply funding a champion, but funding the process. That's what IDBI Federal Life Insurance did by partnering with Pullela Gopichand in Hyderabad.
It was launched in December of 2017. It was an online hunt that we did, where we had the coach of the academy shoot a small 1 minute video, which was then put up on the social media. And we asked for videos of young children under the age of 11 play their game with the similar kind of strokes that was displayed in the video, and send the videos to the academy. We got 1,000+ entries, not just from the from India. We also had entries coming in from Qatar. We had entries coming in from Dubai, Singapore, Malaysia. These videos were then looked at by the coaches at the academy. We had roughly about 8 coaches from the academy who were going through these videos. And from the 1,000+ videos that were received, we shortlisted about 26 children under the age of 11 who came into the academy for one full day of face-to-face selection that was conducted by the coaches of the academy. And out of the entire 26, finally, we selected about 14 children. Out of the 14, finally, after the 2 camps that we had, there were 7 children who were identified to be given 2 years long scholarship to train at the academy.
First day when I came to this academy, well, it was like introduction to Gopichand by everything, and it was very good feeling for me, and it was my best experience in my life.
I was seeing them and I'm so excited. I'm Pullela Gopichand sir is like giving me feeding, helping me for in the, all Indonesia coaches are there. Everybody is helping me. So happy to.
For a child who plays for about 6-8 hours every day, apart from that, does school at times, does other activities. So every day when I look at his fitness, some 20 kilometers he has already clocked. And in spite of that, to be able to get up at 4 every day with the excitement that yes, I have to go and do it. This attitude towards hard work every day, I think has been a huge change, especially for my child, helping him to prepare better and hence becoming a better player.
Whenever you are young, it's always good to have their financial support. That's how parents, I know that's how there won't be so much of a burden on a parent, and that's when there'll be many more parents who can. You know, that's how many parents put in their kids, you know, every time they have some financial support. And I think it's always good to have corporate support, and IDBI Federal Life Insurance is doing a great job in helping the young kids to do well. And I think they're also supporting young kids to play tournaments for their trainings. So it's always good to have that corporate support.
No kid has ever said, I don't want to come in early in the morning. Maybe it's the training which they've had from the very beginning. But if any kid in the academy, and I would say tomorrow morning you pick the youngest of the kids and say, Gopi sir will come in the morning to train you, will you come at 4:15? And I'm sure they'll say yes. And that's the beauty of the sport itself.
I believe these kids are shaping up very well. They're winning a few tournaments, they're participating in a lot of tournaments, and it's all about exposure. They're getting the exposure, they're seeing, they're practicing, rubbing shoulders with the best of the best. And there's no doubt in mind that they will improve from here on. I'm extremely proud of this venture. And if one of these kids in 2024 or 28 win India a medal in any world event or the Olympics, nothing will do IDBI Federal more proud.
But I think Vignesh and Karthik,
because both of them have background in sport.
I think their understanding of sport and their respect for the work which you're doing here was immense, and they've been super supporters, what the least I can say.
Started way back, and since then has already given India multiple Commonwealth medals, the 2012 London Olympic medal, the 2016 Rio Olympic medal, and now the dream lives on. Interestingly, in 2008, Saina Nehwal from this academy made it to the quarterfinals in Beijing. 2012, it became a bronze medal. One step further. 2016 with PV Sindhu, another step further, and it became a silver. Fingers crossed, ladies and gentlemen, 2020 in Tokyo, will this academy give India its first ever gold medal in badminton at the Olympics?
Well, I think this year has been a particularly tough year. I think last year also was tough. Unfortunately, we had kind of two big events, the Commonwealth and Asian Games, in addition to the mandatory rule of the 15 tournaments, literally pushing us to play more than 20 tournaments last year. And this year being the qualifying year and almost five of them in the top 25 of the world kind of vying for that two slots in the men's singles, make it very competitive to qualify for the Olympics.
Right now I'm in a position where I'm coming back from an injury, so it's all build up to the Olympics for sure. So I'm only trying to get better, you know, get fit by August 2020 so that I'll be fully fit for the Tokyo. And meanwhile, I really have to play tournaments and get my ranking points so that I'll be in that ranking so that I can qualify. And after the qualification period ends, I still have a couple of months full training for the preparation to the Tokyo. So it is about getting to that form now.
I think the competition world over is huge. Olympics is everybody's dream, so everybody's going to push and try their best out at the Olympics. So with positive results coming from Satvik and Chirag, definitely I would look at them. Women's singles, we would. And we've seen what Sai Pranit is capable of doing at the World Championship. So I do believe that we have our chances.
And Shrikant.
And of course Shrikant, and the men's singles and the mixed doubles as well. So I do believe that we have a chance. It boils down to having good health, good preparations, and God willing, we'll have that medals.
The quest for excellence in this academy continues. You know, our endeavor was to try and give you a real idea as to what happens in producing champions. All we see is the surface. You see a PV Sindhu going to Rio, a Kidambi Srikanth going to Tokyo, winning a medal, standing on that podium, kissing the medal, hugging it, people going bonkers and busak and celebrations. And you see a Pullela Gopichand sitting at the back, trying to inspire and motivate. But that is not the real story. The real story is one of struggle, of commitment, of passion, of dedication. No people. There are no people at 4:30 every morning. No people at 5 o'clock every morning trying to inspire, trying to motivate. That is what the story is. That's where the real story lies. And that is what we have tried to bring to you. Thanks to IDBI Federal Life Insurance, this academy has got corporate support. Thanks to them, this story will move on. The story of Indian sport over the last 15 years has only gone up. And we have seen that with how badminton has become our second most popular sport after cricket. We have loved bringing you this documentary on India's medal winning factory. And as we said, the number of medals will only grow. Pullela Gopichand, more strength to you. More strength to IDBI Federal Life Insurance. May this partnership continue. Thanks for watching.